I remain yours again, Mike Udenta. President Muhammadu Buhari is likely to be smuggled out of Nigeria to London as his conditions worsened. This is as prime time journalist alleges. Now, we have tried here at Njenje Media to look at all the media houses that has reported on this. Please, forget all the mainstream medias. They will not report these things. Remember when Yar'Adua was brain dead in Saudi Arabia? Channels, NTA, all the mainstream medias, none of them reported it. It was then only Sahara Reporter that was following up what was happening with Yar'Adua. Then, this current APC were in opposition. They were the ones giving Sahara Reporters all those secret information that they were leaking to the public. But that is it. Njenje Media is here to stay, and Njenje Media is playing that role. What we can tell you here at Njenje Media is that the presidency has been in contact with hospitals in Germany to prepare on how to move the president to the United Kingdom if his condition continues to decline. No information have been given on Abakare since he tested positive. If he's recovering or if anything is happening to him, they are keeping everything secret. To tell you that this information is, very, very real. Look, if you go to Premium Times today, you will see the headline that says Coronavirus Nigerian Presidential Villa on Partial Lockdown. What does that mean? If they're on partial lockdown, it means that something is happening within the inner cacos of Asorok. In a bid to check the spread of COVID-19, the presidential villa has gone on a partial lockdown. The president's spokesperson, Femi Adesina, said today, being Wednesday, the 25th of March, 2020. Things are a bit of a low key. Of course, we know that things are a bit of a low key because every country has actually locked their doors. Sources in Asorok today have revealed that the presidency has been in contact with hospital in London to prepare on how to move the president to UK. Because, the whole of Europe is locked down. People are dying. 2 days ago, over 800 people died of COVID-19 in Italy. People are dying right, left, center. Nigeria is not going to be an exception. Maybe the rulers or the misleaders, as I have fondly called them, maybe they will at some point begin to appreciate the people and do the things that they ought to have done many, many years ago. These are hospitals that they ought to have built in the last 5 years, but sorry, they didn't build them. That's why they are trying to run to UK through the back door. But the UK has its own case to deal with. The O2 Arena, many of you who know the O2 Arena in London, they are now converting that O2 Arena into a 2,000-bed hall where they are expecting to take people. They have locked down the United Kingdom. No one is moving on the streets of London except those on essential duties. So how can a country that have locked down its own borders, locking down that is only if no shop is going to be open unless you're selling essential food, you're not going to drive on the road unless you're a nurse, a doctor, a healthcare assistant going to work or coming back from work. Everyone is told to stay at home. Many people are now working online. So how come a nation battling with its own problem, whereas, at the moment there are no doctors, everybody's overstretched, the same people would want to take your own liability? See, again, we all die in this nation because they've cost it. They had 5 years to have fixed at least presidential health hospital, knowing that he was sick, and they did nothing. Now they want to fly him away. Don't be surprised that tomorrow, or some of their supporters would actually come to this broadcast and be saying, no, this is a lie, this is a lie. Whereas the same people that have actually oppressed them are the same people they are defending. And you find out that their mumu never do. The same people that have been oppressing them since time immemorial are the same people they will be defending. We at the media here, we want to expose all the hidden things they are doing, because there is no way you can get a better society by supporting those that have held you down, by supporting those that have sworn that it's not going to be good for you and you cannot enjoy the benefit of a country you called yours. Okay, so this is what is happening. The president, even if you go to Sahara Reporters, you see that Sahara Reporters has an exclusive, report, which they've titled Presidential Intensive Care Unit Activated. as Buhari self-isolates after Abakari tests positive of coronavirus. So how come that Abakari will come back, have met with the president, and those Abakari have met have already all tested positive, and you want to believe them that Buhari hasn't tested positive? You see, the issue is, there is a way nature works. If they like they've been rigging election, let them rig all they care. All we care with the coronavirus result, let them rig it. But remember that corona, when day breaks, would always tell us who won and who lost that his own test result. Nigeria is in a very, very precarious time, and the time ahead is really, really, you know, going to determine how this nation will move. There has been a long while, even when Sore was calling for Nigerians to come out to come and protest, and everybody showed little or no interest. It appears that nature is using this virus to start and do that revolution on our behalf. Since it emerged that Abakari, that is Buhari chief of staff, tested positive for that deadly virus, no one has ever seen or even heard. The last we heard was that he was going to be taken to Lagos. Then you ask yourself, has Lagos now become the new London? So why are they not also making plans to take Buhari to Lagos? You see? Reason. Again, Abakari went to Germany to negotiate with Siemens, the criminal Siemens. He went to Germany to negotiate with Siemens. And what was Siemens for? For our electricity. How can he, if we had a serious nation, Abakari should have been sacked and Buhari impeached, because you have your vice president who was elected with you. You have a minister of power whose duty and whose responsibility by the constitution are to negotiate on anything that has to do with power. But you sideline them and you sent a man no one elected, no one casted vote for, a man just because he is your crony. Today, he has contracted the disease. And what they are trying to do is to whip up sentiment for people to basically say, oh, God bless them for what? Well, again, empathy here. If nature wants to keep them, so be it. If nature doesn't want to keep it, honestly, here at Njenje Media, we are so indifferent. Let whatever that is going to happen, let it happen. Whatever is going to happen, is going to happen. At the end of the day, the people of this country must move forward. Now, okay, so let us keep monitoring what is happening, if Buhari is going to truly, truly be taken to the intensive care unit, or by tomorrow, or even before Friday, we will know if he's going to be flown to London. But rest assured, if he goes to London and go to Abuja House, the people, the Nigerians in London, will definitely break the rule and go to Abuja House and protest and ask him to go back to Nigeria. Because here we are in Nigeria, and here we will all die here, or we'll fix here. Our mumu must do by any means necessary. Once more, I remain Mike Udenta.